What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes, heading to my next service call in St. Albans, Queens. We have a new residential client that's got a problem with their HVAC system. Let's go give them a once over, but at first I gotta go a different route to get around this detour. Gotta love New York City.
How you doing?
Hi.
Yes, how you doing?
I'm early.
Oh.
Okay. I tried calling, but they didn't answer. I figured I was right down the block. So.
Oh my gosh, come on. Come on in.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
How may I help you guys?
We're trying to figure out. Trying to settle. Quiet.
It's okay, doggy.
Calm down now, he's a little... Before you know, he's going to rub him, rub his belly.
That's all right. You're trying to figure out what?
During the summer,
yeah,
we were getting heat. You know what I'm saying? It's like the thermostat and the boiler are not working together somehow or another. Now, it's like it says here...
Except for 94 degrees and 75 in the house.
Yes.
Okay, why do you have it set for 94 degrees?
Because it's not even really achieving this 75. Right now, I have the oven open because it's so cold in the house.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And,
let's go see the boiler.
Okay. Hold on one second. Let me just...
I'm sorry to disturb your breakfast.
No, don't worry, man. It's going to be so... Kyra! Are you out? Because I need to bring the man to see the boiler.
I hope you guys got carbon monoxide detectors in the house.
Yeah.
Yeah?
One right here. Can I bring you? Can I come down? All right, come on.
Yeah? All right.
And the boiler, I can hear the boiler running.
I can hear the boiler running too.
What?
Sounds like an oil boiler.
Gas.
That's a gas boiler?
Yeah, here we go.
Oh my God. Convert it to oil.
Yeah.
Convert it from gas.
I mean,
convert
oil
to gas. Yeah, it rumbles. See, a rumbler.
Yeah. And you know, so I know when I turn the oil switch upstairs and switch to the boiler from the thermostat.
Yeah.
And I know that the boiler kicks on, but then throughout the radiators, you know, saying it's not really getting hot.
When's the last time you had service on this boiler? Maintenance, service, repair, what have you?
Probably last year.
So. Last year? So you're saying that you don't think the thermostat controls the boiler?
I'm saying that, like I said, you see it up there, it says that we had to jack it up to 95. Just the other day, I had it set to 84. It was saying 75 degrees in there. I jacked it up to 90 something, and it went up 1 degree to 78. Then when it got to 78, it dropped back down to 77. You know what I'm saying? And then it says nope. It says call for heat on the thermostat. And then sometimes I'm not getting enough heat. I'm having to keep the oven on. So you know, since you spoke to my wife the other day, we had to make sure the kids, you know, in the house. Warm, so I had to keep the oven on.
When did this problem start?
It's been like this. Well, like I said, as I explained from you, for this during the summer,
the heat was on.
The heat, you know, what I'm saying, it's like gonna be that 80 degree day, and it's blasting heat. You know, what I'm saying, so we like something's gotta be wrong because it shouldn't be getting, you know, what I'm saying, giving us heat. You know, on a beautiful day like that, we tried. I think my daughter even tried taking the batteries out of the thermostat, and I think it was still running.
Yeah, so the boiler will run year-round because you have what we call a tankless coil, which a tankless coil gives you domestic hot water for your showers, faucets,
right.
Tubs, you know, things like that.
Right.
So you have a tankless coil, so the boiler runs year-round. What is going on with this? The boiler runs... You got to be kidding me. The boiler runs year-round. What the...
So who did this?
Well, I'll be honest with you, it's been a couple of people that have worked on this because of the fact that the first person I had come out that converted it had the thing coming out to here, so we couldn't close the door. The man got up in age, I wasn't getting too much satisfaction from him, so I called another guy. Another guy came out and said, oh, the thing is all the way out here, so I put it out here, so I done right. He said, I do right, he put it to where it is right now. It worked for a while, you know what I'm saying?
Then... there are so many things wrong with this picture that I don't even know where to begin. And primarily for safety of you and your family. Seriously. There are so many things wrong with this boiler. The way it's installed, you know, the exhaust piping. You have what we call a horizontal diverter that's installed vertically. That's basically opening flue gases, you know, possibly dumping into this basement. Like, I fear, you know, if I was that guy, I would just call 311 and let the fire department deal with this. Seriously. But I know you know, we're like, you know, you're human like everyone else, and, you know, but there's so many things wrong with this where... You really need to bite the bullet and, like, a hard reset. Start over from scratch. Like, seriously. And I hate to say that. And you know what? I'm going to go to my truck. Let me get my carbon monoxide monitor to make sure that we're not dying here. Right? Because you have open exhaust. You have open gases coming out of that hole right there. I can feel it. You see how it's all white and stuff there? That's hot temperature burning that up. Let me come in.
Put this bad boy zero out outside. And I got my, all right. I ain't taking no chances. I'm gonna go home to my family tonight.
All right, so I just turned on my device outside to make sure we're good though. Okay. And I also am wearing another one, but. Yes, sir. So far so good, but burning up almost over 600 degrees right there. Your boiler is burning, and you have, yeah, there's the carbon monoxide I was looking for. Yeah, you really can't run this. You really can't. You really shouldn't be. I'm not exaggerating here. I have a sensor that we use to test exhaust gases on boilers outside the boiler, in front of the boiler, where that gas control is that replaced the oil boiler, and you have dangerous amounts of carbon monoxide leaving this boiler. So realistically, I am going to turn off the gas. I'm going to turn off the power to this, and you need to make other arrangements, because, you know, it's not safe. Dangerous amounts of carbon monoxide coming out of this boiler into the basement. Now, I don't know if someone's sleeping down here or lives down here, but yeah, it's not good.
So I'm not going to scream at you, so let me ask a couple of questions.
Sure.
So it was oil. Can we convert that back to oil or no?
Yeah, I don't see why not. We don't do that, you know, but you could. I see you have an oil line here. There's an oil filter still there. I don't know where the oil tank is. Oh, there it is. But... yeah, you know, if you put the oil gun back in and make that connection there solid, yeah. Or listen, you have an oil boiler that converted to gas. Can it be done? Yes. Should it be done? No. Right? Would this pass an inspection? Absolutely not. But
okay.
you may be able to get the pieces. Again, I don't know, right? Because we're a licensed plumbing company, right? You may be able to get the pieces from the manufacturer who makes this conversion burner to make that type. You may. But until then, like, I turned the power off. You saw that, but just because I don't want to get a knock on my front door, you know, tonight, tomorrow, whenever, that this family is in the hospital.
I get it. So, Mike, where do we get these pieces? How soon can we find out if we can get these pieces?
Get the what?
I'm just trying
the pieces?
Is there some way, and I don't know your expertise, you tell us, is there some way we could get a used boiler, which would be a lot cheaper, and would that be able to do gas? I don't know. I'm just asking it for you.
Okay, so let's, expertise. I got you. So realistically, you know, the number to make this right is probably around $20,000, right? Because you also have to deal with the gas piping, which is too small. You have 3/4 inch pipe and then some 1/2 inch pipe and some more 3/4 inch pipe. I have to see the meter. But I know it sounds crazy, the cheapest part of the job is the actual boiler itself, right? It's all the fittings that are on here and the material and the labor, and then the boiler. So the boiler itself is really insignificant in total cost of job. If we're trying to be at a certain number, you know, we could do financing if you guys get approved by the bank. But let me go see outside what kind of meter you have, and we could formulate a solution here. Alternatively, the problem is if I touch this, I become responsible for it. Right. So if I take some cement and cement this around there, it's not professional plumbing that I'm comfortable doing.
You just added on to what was already a bad situation.
Yeah.
Mike, I'm comfortable with what you're saying. You don't have to.
Okay. Let me take
anything up against anything. I'm fine with what you're saying. I mean, I'll call for an expert because that's what I need to know, because I keep saying something is wrong. Something is wrong. Right.
Yeah.
So obviously that haven't been sufficient for us. And I knew when I called you, it was going to cost us something, just not sure what it would cost. Hopefully it wouldn't give me a heart attack at this age. But it is what it is. But I have 4 children in there as well.
Gotcha. Is someone running water in this house right now?
Yeah, tell Kyra to open that door. There's some water that's running in that slot sink back here.
Yeah, because I hear like water running, and when I close the valve, it stops. So that may be part. Is like where the back room is.
So right where the back door of the slot machine. I heard it was coming, and then I thought maybe it was just my imagination.
Okay.
So I'm it's
Yeah. Is it here? Okay, thank you. Well. How long has this been running for? To solve that problem. All right, so the faucet is off.
Okay.
Any idea how long the faucet was running for?
I have no idea. I
just heard it like last. I thought I heard it last night, but I wasn't sure because I came to look at the boiler.
Okay. So I turned off the faucet. The faucet was on, and just running hot water continuously. Which is probably, whatever.
Thank God, because our water bill is not high, so.
Well, yeah, that was just basically full blast, faucet being on. Gas meter's not outside, it's in the basement. All right, and it's a 275 with 3/4 inch piping, which needs to be upgraded to 1 inch. I don't care what anyone says about how they could put bubble gum and duct tape on this and make them safe. That is not professional plumbing and HVAC. I'm sorry. It's not happening. After documenting on video, like you just witnessed, an obscene amount of carbon monoxide spilling out of the front of the combustion chamber where that conversion gun is, where that oil burner was, it's just not happening. It's not happening. I turned the power off to the boiler and I said, this one needs to get done. If you want to apply for financing, you can apply on our website, but there's not much that I could do here other than shut her down and make sure that the environment is safe, which is what I did. And if there was any pushback on that, I would have just left and I would have called 911 and let the authorities deal with it, because I am not going to be receiving a knock on my door and jeopardize my family, my livelihood, and my business because someone's life was compromised because of neglect, and I was the last person there and I touched it. But you got it all on video.